Hey, welcome back to the show all about small business jobs and entrepreneurship. We're powered by our good friends at Tandem HR, your solution center. Check them out online, tandemhr.com, or give them a ring, 630-928-0510, 630-928-0510. So I'm holding it up here because for those of you that are tuning in through Facebook Live, you're welcome to Get Down to Business with Shalom Klein. I am thrilled to be joined by the author of this fantastic new book, my very good friend, Justin Breen, the founder and CEO of Brepik. Justin, welcome to the program.
Great to see you again, man.
Absolutely. So, Justin, you have been in the media business, I don't know how it's even possible, but for 20-plus years, and you've worked on and won dozens of editing and writing awards, and you've been involved in countless stories, but for once, you are the story yourself, man.
It's nice to be on the other side of things. You know, I got this book coming out, Epic Business. It comes out May 19th on Amazon, and really excited to see what happens with it, because basically it's the lessons that I've learned in less than 3 years of running a business and taking it to heights that I never imagined possible, and really looking forward to share this stuff with the world.
Well, as I mentioned, you have been involved on the other side of many writing and editing projects. But I think that when I think of you, I think of you know how to tell a story. And that's really the sort of the lessons learned from all of our guests on the show this evening. But you have developed some interesting content. I think you describe it in a word, clicky. It goes viral. That's fascinating. But what you've worked on with your clients and through the years is simply epic. So let's start with that. You are the founder and CEO of Brepik Communications. So tell us the story of Brepik. When did you get started, and what services do you provide?
Sure. So I'll say this as quickly as possible, but about 3 years ago, my salary as a full-time journalist was cut in half. Couldn't find a full-time job. Spent about 2 months trying to figure that out. Started doing some freelancing stuff on the side while I worked full-time. Decided to incorporate it into my company April 16th, 2017. Then spent about 2 months reaching out to 5,000 people to get my first 5 clients. And then when I got my 5th client, resigned from my full-time job. And early June 2017, announced that I had this new company that essentially was created based on how PR firms annoyed me for 20 years when I was a journalist. So most PR firms send these really bad press releases that are totally useless to everyone. And my firm does the exact opposite. It creates actual stories that are super interesting, and it becomes a link on the client's website. And then I take that link and market it all over to media everywhere. And it's been super successful. I have giant clients, small clients, companies in hyper-growth mode, and only work with these amazing visionaries around the world. So again, it's achieved everything and more beyond my wildest dreams.
It's a small business success story. And first and foremost, that's what we like to talk about on the show, talking about small business success. You've been a good friend, and it's been fun watching the story. I watched you when you were in media, and watching your communication. In fact, just on the way over here, on the way into the studio, my wife and I were talking, and my wife is telling me everything that you have going on because you are such an exceptional communicator, and I know it's those skills that you bring to your clients as well. So as I said in one of my earlier segments, I don't want to share all of the secret sauce, but what are some of the tools that you both provide for your clients as well as sort of do yourself that perhaps some of the small business owners that are listening this evening can, again, put into practice to help them communicate their message and make sure it resonates, it clicks, and it goes viral?
So, yeah, I definitely want to talk about in terms of, you know, essentially what my business really is in terms of, you know, what I discovered writing the book. But in terms of, like, actual business, what my firm does, it creates stories that are actually interesting because it's about the person. So no one really cares about what you do for the most part, but they do care about who you are. And if they do care about who you are, they will care about what you do. So it's a very simple thing. And as a journalist, I'm reading, you know, hundreds of these really bad press releases about blah, 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 names blah, 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 it's president, or blah, 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 expands to a new city. No one cares about that. But if you make it human interest friendly or emotional or inspirational, they will care about it, and then they will care about that your business is doing really well.
So you help to unpack that message and disseminate that message. So it sounds like the advice would be genuine, be transparent, be honest. Don't try to hide behind some persona. And you know, some people try to be very polished and buttoned up. And, you know, sometimes that message is that might be who somebody is. But I mean, Justin, people can see something I think very personal about you. When people search your name, when they Google your name, no doubt one of the things that would pop up is this little thing that was on the Today Show, I believe, about a New Year's resolution that you made. And I know it's very personal, but it's out there. So, Justin, why don't we just talk directly about it? Justin, what was your, I think it was the end of 2018. Mm-hmm. What was your New Year's resolution and was it successful?
Yeah, sure. So 2018, I'm very direct and very dedicated to something if I had decided to pursue it. So at the start of 2018, I was telling my wife, Sarah, who's an amazing pediatrician, I'm like, yeah, we should go out once a week without the kids every single week. And we decided to do this date night. We started posting on social media, and it got a ton of traction. I got a huge social media following. It led to lots of stories, including on the Today Show.
Well, so Justin,
really
we're
cool.
Going to pick up that story when we come back in just a minute. I got to squeeze in a quick break.
IDT, putting paper in its place.
AM 560, The Answer.
Back on Get Down to Business with the awesome, awesome author of this brand new book that I'm holding up here, Epic Business. Justin Breen. Justin, you were just telling me about your New Year's resolution, going out on a date night every week with your wife, Sarah. And it was a New Year's resolution that, unlike most of us, you actually kept, and you shared that message, which pretty much is what you do with everything in your life, is you share a lot. Does that ever upset your wife?
No, not really. She understands that that this is the business that I'm in, and you know, you have to get yourself out there. I know when I first started my business, I was talking to an established PR firm, an executive from there, and he said the number one rule of PR is you don't talk about yourself. And I started laughing because I'm like, this is someone who's been in an office way too long because it just doesn't understand how it works. And again, I created my entire business based on how PR firms annoyed me. And, you know, I knew it this specific thing, my unique ability in terms of writing these stories and my connections and pitching them, I knew that I was basically better at this than anyone on the planet. So I just went with it. Now, if you ask me to install a light bulb, God help us all, because I'm terrible at everything else besides this. But, you know, it's just about being confident in yourself and then, again, putting yourself out there. And really what my business is, like, you know, I have a PR firm or whatever, but really what it is, it's just a giant incubator on an international level of connecting extremely high-level people for mutual gain. And the byproduct of that is that I'm just constantly getting intros to these awesome businesses and brands that can afford what I do, that look at things as investments, not costs, and that are really trying to change the world for good. So that's essentially my only clients, is these super high-level visionaries and exceptional businesses now.
Yeah, and you and I have talked about that over coffee, that you feel, I know, blessed and fortunate that you were able to do that each and every day. And I have fun on the air, obviously doing exactly that, meeting some phenomenal, phenomenal people. And I give you credit because I'm on the receiving end of some of those viral and epic stories. Epic, again, the name of the business and the name of the book, Epic Business. So I receive many of those stories, and you tell the story in such a compelling way, and you make my job so easy. So let's segue over to the book, Epic Business, 30 Secrets to Build Your Business Exponentially and Give You the Freedom to Live the Life You Want. So it's sort of a combined message over there of, it's a small business success story, which is what Brepic Communications has been. And you share some of those secrets. So, Justin, when did you decide you wanted to write a book?
Yeah, so there was no intent to write a book at all. I have a giant social media following, and I posted this list of 30 things that I learned in the first 3 months of my company. And what happened is I posted it, and everybody's like, you have to write a book on this. This will change people's lives. People were printing out the list and bringing it to meetings. And the kind of person I am now, when enough high-level people just tell me to do something, I do it. So signed with one of the top micro-publishers in the United States. Her name's Rebecca Paul Greider. She's incredible. She's out in California. So that was late November. Wrote the book in 43 days, and she's going to make it an international and national bestseller. So it comes out on Amazon May 19th, and then soft cover in June or July. I'm planning this gigantic book launch party. Likely it'll be in mid-July. It's going to be incredibly epic. And that's kind of how life is now. You go big or you go home. And when you surround yourself with these amazing visionaries, that's how they all are. They're super positive, very focused, big thinkers, and that's how I am now.
Well, I'm literally counting down the days to the book coming out. I'm excited for it. What I'm holding over here is not the actual book, because Justin wouldn't trust me with the actual secrets, the 30 secrets. I'll get along with everybody else, but I'm counting down to the book launch and the book launch party, which is exciting. Justin, we were talking about this earlier in the show. Obviously, you are in the business of communications, but you are in business. You have a small business. You file taxes, yep, just like everybody else. And that's not something that I know, knowing you, that's not something that you anticipated doing just even a couple of years ago. So what is it about owning a business and being an entrepreneur that shocked you the most?
Oh, my God. That's a tremendous question. And, you know, almost 3 years into this, I think it took me years to figure it out in terms of how you get paid as an entrepreneur. You know, when you're in corporate, for lack of a better term, for 20 plus years, you get a paycheck every 2 weeks, paycheck every 2 weeks. And it's not like that as an entrepreneur. So for the past year, I've been in a very amazing international entrepreneurial program called Strategic Coach. And Dan Sullivan's one of the co-founders, and he had a great video about entrepreneurs should essentially think of themselves as being paid like entertainers, where they get a big payment for performing, and then they have a lot of time to cool down or recharge for their next performance. And when I heard that, I'm like, okay, so now I can get these big paychecks when I get paid to perform, and then I can go a month or 3 weeks without a paycheck, and it's not a big deal. And that really mitigated the shock of, like, not getting paid all the time, and really gave me a lot of clarity about how this life is.
Well, it's certainly been a journey, and I know that I'd say more than anything, what I've watched from watching the growth of Abrapic and watching you sort of in writing this book is you're very open-minded. And it sounds like that's a lot of the advice that you share with the folks that you have coffee with and that you are sort of talking to through this book is being open-minded. You even jumped out of a plane. And that's sort of in a nutshell, and people can find that picture if they Google your name. It's out there. It's that in a nutshell is, A, it's epic, and B, it's also sort of that lesson of entrepreneurship is be open-minded, and you are on this journey. And it's been fun watching you do this. So the book is coming out really, really soon, and you talk about some of those secrets. Of the people that you've met with, is there anybody that you want to give a shout out to? People that I know you've learned a lot. I feel like you and I have been in this journey somewhat along the way. Is there any one or two people that you want to give a shout out to that have taught you quite a bit?
Wow. So Gary Klaibin, super high level financial advisor, but really he's a mentor. He's a coach and strategic coach, and he's most at peace when he's driving 200 miles an hour. He graduated first in his Army Rangers class.
Justin, we're going to pick up more on that in just a minute. Hi.
560, The Answer.
Hey, welcome back to Get Down to Business, the show all about small business jobs and entrepreneurship. We're powered by Tandem HR. Check them out online. Great advice on their website, tandemhr.com. So I've been chatting with my friend and the founder and CEO of Brepic Communications, LLC, the author of Epic Business, and probably the head honcho of some other epic ideas that I don't even know about. But no doubt when he finds out about it, he's going to communicate it. Because that is indeed what you do, Justin. So, Justin, you were just telling us about some of the people that inspire you. I know your clients inspire you. So do you have something that the rest of us business owners need to find out about, that you only attract good people?
Yeah, so that's the number one thing that I learned since starting this business, is do what you're really good at and what you really like to do. And so that's essentially all my firm does, is writes these stories and then pitch them to media. And then I just keep doubling down on that in terms of raising rates and continuing to network and connect with and really care about, and I trust that word, or stress that word, care about people. And what's happened is my clients are just continue to be at a higher level who, again, look at things as investments, not costs. If somebody asks me, what do you cost, I will never work with them because they just don't understand about investing in their business, and they're always going to be thinking about what they're paying as opposed to understanding that an investment will lead to all these amazing, wonderful opportunities that will help their business grow in exponential ways.
Well, Justin, just a couple of years ago, you resigned from a senior position in media. You went off, started Brepik Communications, and I know better than most, some of your initial clients were providing services that are not quite what you're doing today. Now, in 2020, you have a very impressive client base. You're actually an employer. You have people working with you. And what does the next few years hold for Justin Breen for Brepik Communications?
Well, again, through Strategic Coach, which has really helped me visualize my future, this book's going to be a major game changer for me. It's going to take my company to the next level in terms of national and international speaking engagements. That's already started, even though the book's not out. But so my wife, Sarah, she's very pragmatic in a good way. She's only been excited two times since I've started this company, and I'm very happy to say that. But once is when I started the company, she said it was going to do really well. And the second time was when this book was decided to be, when I decided to write the book. And she's like, this book is going to be unbelievable. So knowing I have someone like my wife, who's an absolutely incredible human being in my corner, it makes all the difference in the world. But I just very strongly believe and know that this book is going to change everything and take my company even to the next level.
Absolutely. And it's coming out. It's launching on May 19th, 2020. That's right around the corner. And there's a lot of good advice that will be shared with the business world. And really, it's not just about business. It's called Epic Business, but it's advice. I firmly believe that an entrepreneur is somebody it's a mindset. It's a mindset, and you could be you could be an employee of a company and still be an entrepreneur, and you share a lot of those advice, 30 secrets. I have a hunch that there will be a volume 2 of Epic Business where there might be more than 30. So we won't stick with that number too much, but 30 secrets to build your business exponentially and give you the freedom to live the life you want. That's an Epic Business. Justin Breen, how can people get a hold of you? How can they add themselves to the list so they find out when that book comes out?
Sure. Go to brepikbusiness.com. That's BREPIC business.com, brepikbusiness.com.
And I know on that website they could also link to all of the other things that you're involved in and actually see many of the stories, including that today's show appearance, very impressive, where you made that New Year's resolution about date night. Lots of interesting stories both about you as well as written by you. That's what you do. Justin Breen and Brepik Communications, thanks for joining me here on the air. Once again, you're listening to Get Down to Business. Check me out online, shalomkline.com. You can find my book, as well as download shows from the past 5 years of Get Down to Business, the show all about small business, jobs, and entrepreneurship, powered by Tandem HR. Check out our sponsors, tandemhr.com. We'll talk to you next Sunday, 6 p.m. To success, let's get down to business.